in order to actually get a subject in focus, you have to consider working with your taking lens, get a sharpness through it, and adjusting the focus on the anamorphic attachment lens. Now, this is not really easily to attain, and it does require a little bit of a practice. All what you have to do, just get out there and shoot from various different distances in a different light, different objects and different scenarios, and eventually you'll be able to produce an amazing images. Another level of difficulty is framing a shot. Now, unlike your spherical lens, you know, providing 16:9 ratio, you are pretty much in the ratio of 4:3, or should I say upside down, 3:4, with the anamorphic attachment lens. What happens with the image goes right through here and to your sensor, what you will end up is overstretched and compressed image. Now, why would you want to actually use anamorphic attachment lens? Nowadays, DSLR cameras with their large sensors and all the capabilities, you can create a pretty much cinematic image by a snap of a finger. One thing I can tell you right now you cannot attain through a regular camera is a true cinematic look and the flares you can actually gain by this glass versus your regular camera spherical glass.